मन्दे वाञ्छितलाभाय कर्म किं तन्न कत्यते किं दम्पतिमितिब्रूयाम् उताहो दम्पति इति प्रहितोऽपि सेनामुखे पवनः पदे पदे यदावेद्यमावेदयितुम् आवव्रते तदेव तस्य प्रतिकूलपवनलक्षणं दुर्निमित्तं परिणेमे यदसंस्रत च करात् अस्य दम्भोलिः तदेकम् आयुधविस्रंसनम् अशनिपतनं च इति द्वेधा बभूव दुःशकुनम् सो हि हेड् टु इल् ओमन्स् दट् हेपेण्ड् टु इन्द्र टु जस्ट् गिव् हिम् दट् लिटिल् फियर् आर् दट् डौट् दट् हि मैट् लूस् सो अत्रान्तरे Now, you should remember that he asked Surya to constantly keep on, shining because he did not want the Asuras to gain an upper hand. Right? Nishitini, Yodhininam, Vairavarutininam, Nisha eva mabhut iti, Santata Vasarabhavaya, Sahasrabhanumapi, Abhitaha, Prakashaitu. So he ordered Surya to keep on shining constantly so that they don't gain the upper hand. And because the Asuras are very capable of fighting, they become very strong during the night. Now what happened? Despite those things, Tapana Tirobhavaha, he disappeared. Surya disappeared because of the fight that was happening there. Kamakshi Yana Padikriya. அத்தாந்தரே ஹலோ
அத்தாந்தரே அத்தாந்தரே ரணஹதோபய சைன்ய யோத நிர்பின்ன மண்டலதயா தபன சமந்தாத் உத்தாம
தானவ தனுர்கலத்
உத்தாம தானவ தனுர்கலத் उत्प्रबन्ध नारा च दारिततया च शनैः तिरो अभूत्
These are all examples of a reeti called arabhati where there is a excess of samasa many padas are joined together and made a big samasas to describe the rasam that is going on here veera rasam is what is being described here right So, Atrantare, Rana, Hata, Ubhaya, Sainya, Yodha. Now, there is a belief that, people who attain moksha or attain swarga because of their good deeds in the world, they actually go to swargam after breaking the Surya Mandala. Dvavimau Purushau Loke, two people in this world, Surya Mandala Bhedino, they break through and go past the Surya Mandala and attain Swargam. That is, one is a Veera Swargam, the other is a Yoga Yukta. Yogi also crosses that Surya Mandala and attains Moksha. Parivrat Yoga Yuktascha, a Parivrat or a Sannyasi, who is not just a Sannyasi by name, but Yoga Yuktaha, who is also a practicing Sannyasi. So Parivrat Yoga Yuktascha Ranecha Abhimukoha Hataha. A person who has been killed in the battlefield by facing people, not because he turned his back and someone just hit him. That sort of a person is not going to go into Swarga. So here Rane Abhimukatha Hataha. One who has faced the battlefield and has been killed in the battlefield, killed in war, killed in action. That sort of a person is supposed to break the Surya Mandala and go past the Surya Mandala into Swarga. Each has their own specific Swarga that they go. So Atrantare, meanwhile, now what happened here? In the battlefield, both armies, there were many warriors who died. So both, all those warriors, it was as if they had broken this Surya Mandala and that is one reason. And so Surya disappeared. The other reason for his disappearance is because of the Asuras constantly shooting arrows. Those arrows completely covered the Surya and slowly Surya also became, he disappeared completely. Right? He was covered by everything that was there and so he disappeared. Now what happened? ಅತ್ರಾಂತರೆ ರಣಹತ ಉಭಯ ಸೈನ್ಯ ಯೋಧ. ರಣಹತ ಇನ್ ದ ಬ್ಯಾಟಲ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಡೈಡ್, ಹೂ ವರ್ ಆಲ್ ಕಿಲ್ಡ್, ಉಭಯ ಸೈನ್ಯ ಯೋಧ. ದ ವಾರಿಯರ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಬೋತ್ ದಿ ಆರ್ಮೀಸ್, ವಾಟ್ ಡಿಡ್ ದೇ ಡೂ? ನಿರ್ಭಿನ್ನ ಮಂಡಲತಯ ದೇ ಕ್ರಾಸ್ಡ್ ದ ಸೂರ್ಯ ಮಂಡಲ. ದೇ ನಿರ್ಭಿನ್ನ, ದೇ ಬ್ರೋಕ್ ದ ಸೂರ್ಯ ಮಂಡಲ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಟ್ ರೀಸನ್. ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಒನ್. ದಿ ಅದರ್ ರೀಸನ್ ಇಸ್ ಸಮಂತಾತ್ ಅರೌಂಡ್ ಎವ್ರಿವೇರ್ ಉದ್ದಾಮ ದಾನವ ಧನುರ್ ಗಲತ್ ಉತ್ಪ್ರಬಂಧ ನಾರಾಚ ದಾರಿತಯ. ದಾರಿತತಯ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಬೀಯಿಂಗ್ ಹಿಟ್ ಬೈ ನಾರಾಚ. ನಾರಾಚ ಇಸ್ arrows. Arrows, because of being, they were constantly being shot from the bow. Dhanur galat utprabandha naracha. Utprabandha is they're increasing, I think. Sorry, utprabandha means they have a great feathers. Prabandha is also feathers, that's what he says here. So utprabandha naracha, those bows which have big feathers, those bows which came from Galat, from the dhanu, whose dhanu, whose bow it is, Uddama Danava. Uddama were very powerful asuras. So these powerful asuras shot arrows from their bows. Because of that reason also, Shanehi Tapanaha Tiro Abhut. Slowly he just became he just disappeared. Now, the idea here is what he is trying to say. Sviyopi daiva durvipakat parakiyaha abhut. The dhvani that you get from here is, if your fate is not conducive to you, if it is not in accordance to what you want, it is not an anukula daivam, then even a person who is in your team acts as if he is from another team. See, he has asked Surya, that is why I told you to keep that in mind, where santata vasara bhavaya sahasrabhanum api prakashayitu. Because they will become very strong in the night, he did not want it to become night. But Surya disappeared because of their, that tapasa shapam, that the curse of the devas was so strong that even a person in their own team became an enemy team. Whatever the actions that Surya was doing, even that became conducive for the enemies to fight. So it became night. It was like night. So the result of Surya disappearing was an anukula samayam for asuras. The asuras also found that it was the perfect time for them because the night gave them victory. The next shloka.
Mahodi, I have a very childish question.
Yeah, no problem. Tell me.
So how can the people in the battle die if they're already in Swarga?
They will die.
I mean, they're not like Sashariram, right? They're just, this is just my uha. I'm just trying to think how we can, I can take that concept in. It's very childish, but it's also a little confusing.
So the concept is being in Swarga is different from attaining Veera Swargam.
Okay.
Veera Swargam is a concept entirely. See, it is only a concept. It is not a place that they go to or something like that. It is what the punya that the Atma attains. Even if they are in Swarga, it is not that they have everything that is there in Swargam. There are only certain portions that they can enjoy. See, Veera Swargam is something different which can be attained only if you die in battle. And they, when they die in this battle, and this is the battle between the devas, so death is possible for them. Even you say death by natural death is not possible, humans cannot kill them, that is not possible. But between asuras and devas, they can be killed.
Oh.
Right, that is possible because they are fighting for their life there.
Oh, okay.
And in whichever, see, they have not attained moksha here. Again, it is still they are in a point where, see, if you are in a good position in Bhumi, you have say 100 merits in your bank. It is like a bank for you. Punya and Papa are like banks for you. You know,
yeah.
Two accounts you have. So you have 100, then you are in a good position in the bhumi. If you have 1,000, you will probably get swargam. And in those 1,000 also, it is, if you have died in the war, then you will attain something called Veeraswarga. Those things are much different. So the benefits that you get out of Veeraswarga is different.
Okay.
Even the same way, even Papam, you have different types of Naraka. And there also, if you don't have a son, you go to one type of naraka. If you kill someone, it is another type of naraka. If you just, torture someone, that is a different type of naraka. If you talk badly to someone, that is a different type of naraka. So it is like a room in each one, no?
Oh.
You have to imagine only.
Yeah.
That such things happen.
Okay, thank you.
It's a very valid question.
Matrix.
Matrix.
Yeah. Can they die? Even though they're only in the projection, yes, you can die.
Correct. Yeah.
Even though it's not your.
That's what it is. It's such an imaginative. It is an idea, then. Swarga itself is an idea where you're talking about punya that you have accumulated, and because of this you attain something. Ana kshine punya martalyokam vishanti. As your the punya level goes down, you will be pushed down to the bhumi to enjoy something else.
So ivalu sharirathe elandittu bhumi lokam.
Definitely. They will also get rid of their bodies and bhoomi ki varuva. Kshine punye martyalokam vishanti varuva. Adhula vandhu idhuve illa sandeyame illa. It is only a gradation. Swarga is not the ultimate. It could be considered as the ultimate for a karmakandin. Ana angiyum vandhu karma palanla vandhu aasa vekkada pandravan vera. Even within the karma kanda, people who perform the karmas, there is, because see, when the Advaitins came in, you should look at it as a historical part where the karma kanda existed before the Advaitins, and they were talking about how swarga is the most important part. So any action that you perform is always towards that goal of attaining swarga, and they thought that that is the greatest thing. When the Advaiti came in, he pointed out that the latter part of the Vedas talk about something beyond all these things. When Nachiketas asks, he says, asti iti kechit, nasti iti kechit. There is life after death and there is no life after death. People talk about it. What do I do about it? So what is the rahasyam? I cannot ask anybody other than Yama. That's what he says. So that is when they think about something beyond swargam. So, in order to, accommodate that concept of moksha also within the Karmakanda, people came up, the Bhashya, those who wrote the commentaries on the Karmakanda, they came up with the concept of, doing an action without giving any thought to the phala. If you don't think about the phala, swarga kamo yajeta, I am not thinking about the swarga, I am only doing my duty. I am performing all of these, and if these come as an addendum, I am okay with that. But my goal is to only perform that duty, thereby attaining moksha. A place where I am not looking at the phalan, and I am only achieving certain things because I have done certain things, that's all. Not because I want these things. So they made that little distinction after they thought that, the Advaitins have an upper hand when they say about moksha and everything. Because they pointed out, the Advaitins pointed out that Kshine Punya Martyalokam Vishanti. You have a certain type of apurva that has been, that will take an action. Apurva is those punya karma, punya actions that you have done, they all come in the form of an apurva. And the moment the apurva balance is reduced, where does he go? Was the question. That is when the Advaitin said, you know, you have to come back to the earth because that is the karma bhumi and that is where you can perform actions to attain something else. Whereas if you do it anywhere else, it is not going to give you that palan. Right? Okay. We'll go to the next one. So, atrantare ranahato bhaya sainya yodha nirbhinna mandalataya tapanas samantat uddamadanava dhanurgalat uprabandha naracha darita tayacha shanaistirobhut. Next. Shripadi.
Asuranam anukula samayaha atipramandhat ishujala vrishtehe apakramacha dyumanehe akante asit tamisra jayada ripunam pachelima bhagya parampara iva.
Pachelima seems to be his favorite word here. Atipramandhat ishujala vrishtehe ishujala vrishtehe atipramandhat dyumanehe akande apakramat cha. Two things contributed to the victory, or the victory is, that is the start of the victory, right? Jayada ripunam jayada asit ratrihi, that is here tamisra is ratri, tamisra, that which spreads tamas or andhakara is ratri. So tamisra, the night, became provided victory for the ripu or the enemies. Just like how, you know, the change of fortune, sudden change of fortune, it's like a windfall. The moment you have a windfall, everything will start becoming right. If there is one bad thing that happens, then parampara, there will be a series of bad things that happening. In the same way, if one good thing happens, then adutthadutha abadiye nalladhu nadandundey varumba. That is next, it is like a series of good things, good fortune that keep on happening. It was like that for them, right? So suddenly, akande dyumanehe apakramat cha so tapanaha tirobhut. Surya suddenly dyumanehe apakramat, because the Surya went away. Dyumani, dyu is akasha, manihi is like a jewel. Surya is like a jewel in the akasha. So dyumanehe apakramat, the first time I came across this was in Dashakumara Charitam. That is where I came across that word. Dyumanehe apakramat cha. So when the akasha, the jewel of the akasha, which is Surya, apakramat, when he moved away because of that, panchami, hetu. So ishujala vrishtehe atiprabandhate cha. Next, there was an incessant, atiprabandha is continuous rainfall of arrows. Ishu jala vrishtehe, because of the rain of arrows that happened, atiprabandhat continuously, because of that also, ripunam tamisra, tamisra, the night, ripunam jayada asid, gave a victory to the enemies, just like how bhagya panktihi, bhagya parampara iva, which is pachelima. Pachelima is that which is approaching fruition. You have a lot of fortunes that you have done. You have done a lot of punya karma. Everything is like a bank balance or like an FD. And you don't know which FD is going to mature now, which fixed deposit is going to mature now. So it is, this is like a series of fortune that are going to mature at this point. That pachelima is called that which is approaching fruition. Right? You may have, each one may have a different time. But if suppose one set of things have a maturity date as the same, it's like that for the enemies. So ripunam jayada abhut, if they were all maturing at the same time, just like that, this tamisra, this night, which happened because of what? Because of two things. Suddenly the Surya went away, and at that point of time, a lot of arrows were also falling continuously at that point of time. So that tamisra, the night, became a victory giver. Bhagyada, jayada asit, it gave a victory to the asuras. And that form of victory, how was it? No, he starts a gadya to describe their sahasam, no, what they did. Until now, we saw how the Amaras were behaving, the Devas were behaving. Now we have to see how the Asuras were behaving because they got the victory here. Right?
Atkshanam cha punaha anukshana upachiyamanam amarabalam upakshiyamanam atmabalam cha nirikshitum api atitikshavaha atitikshavaha tarakshava iva bubhukshitaha danda shuka iva danda ghatitaha bala bana shambara jambha namuchi virochana mukaha mahasuraha sarabhasam avamuchya varavanam.
So all these asuras immediately they varavanam avamuchya, they put on their varavana armor. Now tatkshanam, at that moment, punaha, again, it seemed as if they could not even look at, or they were intolerant. Titiksha is the controlling or tolerating power, right? They wanted to tolerate what they were. So atitikshavaha means those who could not tolerate the devas showing off their strength. Anukshana upachiyamanam amarabalam nirikshitumapi atitikshavaha. They did not even, they could not even tolerate atitikshuhu to see nirikshitumapi. They could not even, they did not even want to see amarabalam, the deva strength, anukshanam upachiyamanam, which was increasing every moment. Upachiyate, increasing, which was continuously increasing at every point. Because they had described that big gadyam about the deva's prowess, right? So it seemed as if they were intolerant to see, not even face, just not even seeing. They could not even see the amarabala increasing every moment. And then upakshiyamanam atmabalam, their own strength also was, sorry, apakshiyamanam, their strength was also decreasing. Not upakshiyamanam, because upakshiyamanam is again it is only increasing. Let me check the text. Apakshiyamanam only. They could not tolerate the increase of amarabala, and they did not tolerate the decrease of their own strength. Atma balam apakshiyamanam atma balam cha nirikshitumapi atitikshavaha, intolerant. How are they? Tarakshavaha iva bubukshitaha. Tarakshuhu is a type of tiger which is very hungry. Bubukshitaha tarakshavaha iva. So a vyagra which is hungry is called tarakshuhu. Some people translate it as a hyena also, which is constantly hungry and looking around for any type of mamsa. They also say that Tarakshu is a hyena. Some people also say that it is a vyagra vishesha. So Tarakshavaha iva bubukshitaha, being hungry like hyenas or tigers. Hyenas are more like it because they're talking about asuras, right? Danda ghattitaha dandashukaha iva, like serpents which have been hit by danda, by a stick. These asuras, immediately they put on their armors. Who are the asuras that put on their armors? Bali. Bali is Prahlada's grandson. Bana. Banasura is Usha's father. That is the one who married Pradyumna. Married Aniruddha, right? Yeah, Aniruddha's father-in-law, I think, is Bana. Shambara is the one who was killed by Pradyumna. If you remember, he is a great magician also. He is well-versed in magic. Shambara, Jambha and Virochana are Prahlada's sons. Namuchi is another type of asura who was again killed by Indra later. He had varam where he could not be killed by water or something like that. So water and air, or Indra used the foam of the water to kill Namuchi. That's one type of asura. These are all the names of the asuras who were fighting during the Samudra Mathana time. So Mahasuraha, Mahasuraha, Sarabhasam, immediately with a great excitement, they put on their armor. How did they prepare themselves? So this is how they started preparing themselves. Next.
So Mahasuraha can also mean, I mean, here it is Mahasuraha, but it for Mahasuraha also it is Mahasuraha.
Yes, you can change it. It depends on the way you do the samasam. It also means Brahmanas. Mahasuraha also can be Brahmanaha because they are the devas among the Bhumi, the people who are there in the Bhumi. That is also there.
Oh.
Here, Mahan cha Asuraha yaha Mahasuraha.
Avabhadhya godha anguli tranam api nahya nishangam akshaya shara purita utsangam adhiruhya shatangam ayojita khara turangam abandhya nitileshu bhrukkuti vibhangam asevya virapanam alambya samshaptaka vratam Anugnyapya parasparam.
So avabadhya godha angulitranam. Angulitranam is something that is a protection for the fingers. Maybe it is a type of gloves. You have, if you look at the people who spar nowadays, they have a lot of these armors that they put on, right? It's like that. So some glove type of thing should be there, which is angulitranam, something which protects the fingers. And godha is the material is godha. Is what the Vyakhyata says, or it is also a samnya. The name of that gloves is also called a godha. That avabadhya, they put it on. Apinahya nishanga. Nishangaha is the tunira or what is that called? Quiver. They filled their quiver with full of arrows. Akshaya shara purita utsangam. The quiver's utsanga, in inner portion, was purita, filled with akshaya shara, non-decreasing arrows. That is, it constantly kept on refilling by itself. I don't know how, but it just happened, right? There were asuras, they also could do magic. So the sharas, the arrows that they had filled with the in the quiver were akshaya, they did not even decrease. The quiver was always filled with the arrow, and such a quiver, apinahya, they put it on themselves. Adiruhya shatanga ayojita khara turangam. Shatanga ratham. Ratham is shatanga because it has hundreds of different parts which make up the chariot. So a chariot which was pulled, ayojita, which was tied with turanga is horse and khara is a mule. Because it is Asura's chariot, it was pulled by mules. So khara, turanga, ayojitaha, rataha. Adiruhya, they climbed onto such a chariot which was being pulled by horses and mules. Next, abandhya, nitileshu, brukuti, vibhangam. Nitileshu on their forehead. Brukuti, vibhangam. Vibhanga is a curve of the eyebrow. So it's like, the moment you are very arrogant and you show your arrogance on your face, the first thing is the eyebrow that takes a different shape. So here the Brukuti Vibhangam is like either with anger or with arrogance. They showed their arrogance or their anger with their eyebrow curving on their forehead. Abadhya, taking... or making a curve with their eyebrow on their foreheads. Next, asevya virapanam. Virapanam is the alcohol that you take just before you start fighting to make you more strong. That is called virapanam. Asevya, drinking that. Alambya samshaptaka vratam. Samshaptakaha is a person who takes a promise that he will not retreat from the battlefield. Samayat yuddhat yaha na nivartayami iti shapatam karoti. Samshaptakaha saha tadrisha virasya vratam alambya. They take on such a promise. and anyonyam parasparam anugnyapya. Anugnyapya is they take leave of each other. Okay, see you after some time. Let me go and fight this person. That is how they were preparing themselves. Okay. Anugnyapya parasparam. What did they do?
Apurayanto dingmukhani gunadvanibihi avabhramshayanto gaganatalat uduni api attahasaihi visangnyantaha khadga vichurrena vikshitum agatani siddha charana mandalani vismapayantaha smara samrambhenaiva karmandinamapi kalahanandinam utsarayantaha padatam uruvegena parichurnayantaha sthan pariga abhighataihi vidravayanto hayan karatalikabhihi vighurnayanto matangajan anguliya anguliyantranena.
So apurayantaha dingmukhani. Dingmukhani, all the directions. Gunadvani bihi, by the sound of the guna is the bowstring. The sound of the bow, with the bowstring sound, they filled the entire directions, all the directions. Apurayantaha. Next, gaganatalat attahasaihi uduni api avabramshayataha. They laughed in such a with loud sound that they pushed down all the stars from the sky. Gaganatalat, from the sky, uduni nakshatrani api avabramshayantaha patayantaha. They pushed them down, making the stars fall down. Visamnyayantaha khadga vichuranena vikshitum agatani siddha charana mandalani. A lot of these siddha charana and all are divine beings who came to watch. Vikshitum agatani, those who came to watch these siddha and charana groups, they made them faint. Visamnya, samnya is consciousness. Visamnya vigata samnya kurvanti karayanti. So they made them lose their consciousness. With what? Khadga vichuranena, khadga kampanena. They used their sword, they raised their sword, or you know, the what you call as the brandishing their sword, right? That is what they, that is that vichurana. Just shaking their sword this way and that way. With just shaking their sword, they made the siddha and charana who came to see lose their consciousness. Next. Vismapayantaha samara. Smara is manmatha, samara is yuddha. Be careful when you read that. So samara sambrameyanaiva, sambrambheyanaiva, karmandinam api, kalahanandinam karmandinam api, vismapayantaha. See, usually the person who starts any quarrel is a bhikshu. Who is that bhikshu? Sannyasi Narada. So here karmandi is a bhikshu. Or a sannyasi. So making us even forget that Narada, who loves Kalaha, because of their enthusiasm for war, people just forgot about Narada himself, because Narada is the person who always starts off everything. But here, these are the people who are so enthusiastic about fighting. So samara sambrambhena, with their enthusiasm for war, they made everybody forget. Vismapayati, vismarati, vismritam karayati is vismapayati. Nich, everything is a nijanta here. Karmand kalahanandinam, the one who is who loves quarrel, that sannyasi also, they made everybody forget him. They made everybody forget Narada. Next, utsarayantaha padatam uruvegena. Uruvegena, with their the force or the speed of their thigh, that is by running, they pushed all the padata. Padata is the foot soldiers. They made the foot soldiers also run with their speed, where their running speed. They were more fast than the foot soldiers. Parichurnayantaha rathana, they powdered the chariots everywhere with their parigha abhigataihi. Parigha, I told you, are iron bars which they used to put as the door tapad, argala, which is used as an argala, those with the with hitting of those iron bars, they powdered the chariots. Hayana karatalika vihi vidravayantaha. They clapped with their hands, karatalika, clapped with their hands, and with those clappings, they made the horses run. Hayana vidravayantaha. Matangajana anguli yantranena vigurnayantaha. They swirled the elephants with just the snapping of their fingers. Anguli yantranena matangajana, the elephants vigurnayantaha, they swirled them. Bhramayanti. Next.
Here, karmandina, karmandinam api. So, karmandinaha itikte naradaha.
Karmandi is actually karmandi is sannyasi.
Oh, okay.
Because of the adjective kalahanandi, we understand that he is talking about the sannyasi who is Narada.
Oh, okay. What is the vigraha vakyam for karmandi?
Karmandi. Ah, interesting. I didn't think about it. Okay. Karmanda is a person who wrote that Bhikkhu Sutra, which is Buddha, right? But this only applies to him because of the adjective. Whereas a Karmandi is a Bhikshu, one who reads that Bhikshu Shastra, Sutra, the Buddha Sutra. Karmanda is the person who has written those Sutra.
Oh.
But it won't, Narada is not a person who has read the Buddha Sutra, right?
Yeah.
The Bhikshu, it's called Lakshana, where it does not apply in particular, the literal meaning does not apply, and you go to the associated meaning or the indicated meaning, which
because,
is the,
yeah, because of Kalahanandi.
Because of the Kalahanandi, yes.
Okay.
Samvarta
Maruta Avartita Sagara Gartha Durdarsha Vaktra Vivara Ullasata Ullasat Leli Han Nija Rasana Avalokana Janita Sadhvasa Dvasta Chetanam Asadhya Sena Mukhe Nivishtam Antakam Apahritya Tadiyameva Kala Dandam Amogham Abhihatya Tenaiva Tam Adimam Jayam Apedire.
So Mahasuraha Adimam Jayam Apedire. Those Vigurnayantaha and everything comes to it is Anvaya with it is connected with the Mahasuras, right? So Mahasuraha Maha Asuraha Adimam Jayam Apedire Apedire, they got their first victory. How did they get their first victory? The one who was in the front, which is Antakaha Yamaha. Yama is there in the front. Sena Mukhe Nivishtam Antakam Asadhya. They came to Antaka, that is Yama, who was in the front of the battlefront. Asadhya, they reached him. Tadiyameva Kala, that I'll come to that big samasa that we saw at the end. Okay, so let me get the meaning out first. So Kaladandam, Tadiyameva Kaladandam, Apahritya. They pulled or they took away his Kaladanda, the scepter that he has in his hand, right? They pulled away his scepter and Tenaivatam Abhihatya. They used his own Kaladanda to hit him and got their first victory. Now, how could they approach Antaka? How could they approach Yama? It seems very, very nice way and just like that, you know, the one where if you are in Swarga, how will you get to Swarga? How will you die and get into Swarga? It is like that. It's that catch 22 situation. Huh? The same way he shows here, Yama was looking at himself and he was surprised, it seems. Huh? See, people who die are fall into Yama's mouth. That is what we understand from the Puranas. Yama Mukhe Patitaha, right? That's what we say. So here, Yama was looking at his own face, his own mouth, And his own tongue, which was trying to grab all the lives of all the warriors who were dying in the war. And his chetana, his consciousness was dvasta. That is, he fainted by looking at it, it seems. Nice way of understanding. So Yama, who had lost his consciousness, dvasta chetanaha. Why? Because of sadvasa fear. How did the fear come about? Janita, it came because he was looking at his own tongue. Nija rasana avalokanena janitaha sadvasaha. He looked at his own tongue and he was afraid of it, and so he lost his consciousness. Now, how was this tongue? Lelihana iva ullasanti. Lelihanaha is sarpaha, or lelihana is also ledhum ichchati lelihana. That which wanted to lick, you know, the forked tongue of the snake is what comes and kills people, right? That is why it wants to lick, or it wants to touch and kill people with that. So here also he imagines the Yama Mukha to be with a tongue which is like the snake, or which wants to touch people, or which wants to pierce people. Okay, so lelihana nija rasana avalokanena, it was shining ullasanti, that nija rasana was shining inside the vaktra vivara, the mouth cavity of Yama, and that mouth cavity was durdarsha, it was difficult to look at. Dukhena darshitum dukkham janayati. It was very difficult to look at that mouth cavity because it was like a sagara gartha, like a huge whirlpool in an ocean, which was avartita, created by samvarta maruta. If there is a samvarta, is pralaya. Pralaya kala marutena avartitaha, as if the ocean was just swirled by the pralaya kala vayu, and there was a big whirlpool created there. Imagine that whirlpool, how difficult it must be to look at it, even look at it, not even approach, huh? Just to look at it. Tadrasha sagara gartavat durtarshaha vaktra vivaraha. In that vaktra vivara, this nijarasana jihva was just shining. Ullasanti nijarasana, lelihana iva nijarasana, rasanayaha avalokanena janitaha sadvasaha bhayaha. He was very afraid to look at his own mouth, which was just grabbing all the lives of all the warriors who were dying there. So that is why he was just stambita iva, dvasta chetanaha, because he was just frozen with fear. They could easily approach Yama and they caught him. Apahritya tadiyameva kaladandam, they took his kaladanda and hit him with his own. Kaladanda abhihatya tenaiva tam abhihatya adimam jayam apedire. So anybody who is there in the front, the senapati who is there in the front, if you approach him and kill him, that is your first victory. The next is you look at the other adhyaksha, sena adhyaksha, those who are all officers of the other divisions, right? The next one is Agni. Yeah. No. He describes Yama's problem and then he moves to Agni. Now, if you kill Yama, who is going to take his life? That is a doubt here, right? Again, the same situation. So he says, Yama's pranaha kanteyeva jugurnire. His life was as if it was just in his throat. Nobody could just take it out of his body because there was no other antaka to take it out, it seems. That's what he says in this shloka. Read it. You have a doubt in the other one?
No.
Okay, yeah.
Kala danda hatasyasya kante prana jugur nire antakam yadhatam netum antakonya na antakonyo na vidyate.
Hatam antakam netum anyaha hantakaha na vidyate. Kaladanda hatasya asya. So kaladandena swiyena kaladandena eva hataha saha yamaha. Tasya kante. He was hit by his own kaladanda, right? So tadrisha yamasya kante eva tasya pranaha, his life or the pancha pranaha, the five different vital airs that are there in each in a body, the moment the prana goes out of the shariram, that is when the body is declared dead. So the pancha pranaha that are there in the body, that is your prana, apana, samana, udana, brahma. Correct? Yeah. Pancha pranaha. Those pancha pranaha, jugur nire, they were swirling inside his own throat. They could not get out, it seems. Why? Because those prana have to be taken out by Yama himself. Now, who will take that from him? So, yad dhatam is actually yad hatam, antakam, the antaka or Yama who was hit. Tasya pranana netum anyaha hantakaha navidyate. What to do? So, antakasya pranana netum anyaha antakaha nasti iti karanat. Tasya pranaha kanteyeva jugur nire. They were constantly babramuhu, right? They were constantly swirling inside his throat itself, and they did not know how to come out. That was the type of torture that he was experiencing. Kaladanda hatasyasya kante pranaha jigur nire antakam yadhatam netum antako anyo navidyate. See, this is where, just one simple thing I wanted to point out. We're talking about the torture that Yama is facing, but we are actually enjoying it, in the sense we love the way he has written it. That is what is rasaswada. You are not feeling afraid, but you are enjoying the way he has written. That's the difference between your own experience of the bhava and when it becomes a rasa. That is the difference between the sthayi bhava and the rasa. I will anyway read it when you read other Alankara Shastras like Pratapradriyam or Kavya Prakasha. Now he goes on to the next person, which is Agni. What happened to Agni now?
Parshvataha tasya pare kechit atichira uparodha samvardhita pratigha anala vyatikara vishesha bhishana jwala kalapa durapam api parivritya jatavedasam prashammaya parusha hunkara bhayankaraihi mukhamarutaihi asya dussaham jyotihi apakrishya asya vahanam mesham agra charana graham ahritya shaktimapi asya hasta talat.
So parshvataha, if you remember, senamukhe antakam adishya parshvataha pavana pavakau, right? In that gadyam where the sena sannivesha, we were talking about how he was dividing everything. So on the sides he had pavana and agni. So first attack was antakaha. The next we talk about Agni and Pavana. Pavana will come later. First, they talk about Agni. So what happened? Tasya Parshvataha, Indrasya Parshvataha, Kechitu Pare, Anye. The other asuras, some of them, what did they do? Jatavedasam Parivrutya. Jatavedaha is Agni. Again, Jatam Sarvam Vetti iti Jatavedaha. Whatever is born, he knows anything that has been created, and he knows the truth about everything that has been created. Or he also gets everything. Jatam Vindati Labhate. Anything that has been created also, that is at the end of everybody's life, you burn them, right? That is also another connotation. But I think the first thing is Jata Vedaha is he knows everything that has been born. So Jata Vedasam Agnim Parivrutya, they surrounded Agni. How was this Agni? Durapam api, even though it was difficult to go near him. Because of what? Bhishana Jwala Kalapaha. He had a great group of flames, which was Bhishana, very terrible to look at, fearsome flames. The flames were very fearsome because of the vyatikara, sambandha of the anala, agni. How was this agni? He, see, for a long time, every time the asuras want to show their supremacy over the devas when there has been a fight between them. And if the asuras had a supremacy over the devas, the first thing they would do is, you know, torture all these devas, and Agni would be reduced to a kitchen fire. That is his first thing that they would do. Actually, in I think Champuramayana, he says, Rudhi, what? Havyavahana iti Rudhi Samyakaha. Rudhi means that if, for example, you say Pankajaha, Pankatu Jayate, right? Pankatu Jayate means that which comes out of mud. So that which comes out of mud can be any worm or kita, even flowers. It can also be lily, but by rudhi or by popular convention, the word pankaja means only lotus. Nobody talks of a lily as pankaja. Nobody talks of moss as pankaja or a kita as pankaja. So that rudhi. So here, he would say in Champuramayana that Agni was reduced to just like a popular convention. His name is Havyavahana. He does not take the oblations that have been offered to the devas to the devas. He does not do that at all, it seems. So he was confined to the kitchen and only to be as a fire in the kitchen. So that is the Uparodha. Ati Chira Uparodha Sambardhita Pratigaha Kopaha. Tadrisha Kopayeva Analaha Agni Rupena Atra Parinamate. So Atichira, for a long time, Agni has been confined, Uparodha, he has been jailed for a long time, and because of that, his anger has been increased. Samvardhita Pratigaha, Tadrisha Pratigha Analaha Kopaha. Okay. Vyatikara Vishesha, because of that Sambandha. Ete api garhapatya parogaha pavakaha rudi shankavaham hutavahakyaha vahantaha. That is the quotation from Champuramayana. Rudi shankavaham. Just thinking about that. Okay. So, atichira uparodha, because of being confined for a long time, his anger had increased. So, samvardhita kopanala. Vyatikara, because of that sambandha, Vishesha in particular because of that sambandha with the kopam, the jwala, the flames have been increased to a very fearsome level. Because of those flames, durapam api jata vedasam, it was difficult to approach Agni. Even though he was difficult to approach, they came and surrounded him. Next, Parusha Hunkara Bhayankarehi Mukamarutaihi Asya Dussaham Jyotihi Prashamaya. They extinguished his flames, Dussaham Jyotihi, intolerable flames, with what? With just their wind that came from their mouth. Just a hoo-hoo, they just blew wind from their mouth with a Hunkara, with a sound of hum, which was very Bhayankara and Parusha, rough. With those wind from their mouth, they just extinguished prashamaya dussaham jyotihi asya agnehe dussaham jyotihi prashamaya. They pulled his vahanam. His vahanam is mesha or ram. Chaga vahanaha is agni. Agracharana graham, with the front foot they pulled his vahanam, that is a ram. They pulled his vehicle ram by its front foot. Agra charana graham. Agra charanam charana grahanena mesham apakrishya. Shakti mapi hastatalat asya. His ayudham is shakti. They also apakritya pulled his ayudham from his hand. And what did they say? They were laughing at him, ridiculing him by saying all these things. What were they saying?
Are re labdaha ayam annaharaha kratubhujam havyavahaha nama nirjara pashadaha tadadya nirvapayata enam udakumbhaihi nikshipata enam apupikanam vashe mahanaseshuhu maivam
udbodhayatava.
उद्बोधयत एनम् उचितैः मुखमारुतैः हस्ते कुरुत च एनम् अद्यैव दुग्धं दग्धुम् अमरावतीं परित्यजत रेरे बालिशा बाडवः अयं शिखां प्रदर्शयति इति परिहसन्तः परिक्षिपन्तः तर्जयन्तः ताडयन्तश्च पलाययामासुः असुरभटाः एनम्
असुरभटाः एनं जातवेदसं पलाययामासुः पलायति रन्स् पलाययति मेक् समवन् रन् सो असुरभटाः द वारियर्स् मेड् अग्नि रन् बै सेयिङ्ग् आल् दीस् थिङ्ग्स् वाट् वेर् दि डूयिङ्ग् अरे रे लब्धः अयम् अन्नहरः अन्नहरः वन् हू इन् अ स्टील्स् फुड् in the name of what kratubujam havyavahaha nama he is named as havyavahaha havyam vahati havyam ityukte home jushtam havyam what you put is an oblation in the fire is called havyam he takes that havya even if indra comes and stands nearby and puts out his hand and says give me the havyam you are not supposed to give it You are only supposed to put it in the Agni and only Agni is the messenger and he will take it to Indra. That is when it is Sapala. If you directly give it to Indra also, it is not Sapala. So he is called Havyavahaha. Havya, Kratu Bhujam, those who perform Kratu Yaga. Havyavahaha Nama, this person who is named as Havyavaha, he is actually what? Annaharaha. He steals all the food. And he is nirjara apashadaha apashadaha itu neechaha jalman nirjaraha those who do not have any old age deva he is the neecha among nirjara or the devas here he is labdham labdaha we have got him tad adya let us nirvapayatayenam udakumbaihi with the lot of udakumbaihi with water pots let us just extinguish him nirvapayatayenam extinguish him and then nikshipata एनम् आपोपिकानां वशे महानसेषु महानसः इस् किचन् महानसेषु इन् द किचन्स् आपोपिकानां वशे प्लेसिम् इन् द हेण्ड्स् आफ् यु नो एट् द टास्क् आफ् मेकिङ्ग् अपूप पपडं पुट् हिम् इन् द टास्क् आफ् मेकिङ्ग् दट् आपोपिकानां वशे निक्षिपत त्रो हिम् इन् दट् टास्क् अण्ड् देन् नो नो मैवं मैवम् No, no, let's not do that. This is Akshepalankara. Okay, whatever you are saying, you are, what is that? Negating your own words and saying that. So, maivam, yenam, uchitaihi, mukam arutaihi, udbodayata. Let's kindle him with our mouth, winds from our mouth by blowing. Let us kindle him more and let's, what shall we do? Haste kuruta. Put him in your hand and adyaiva, now itself, today itself, amaravatim dagdum yenam haste kuruta. Put him in your hands and, the amaravatim dagdum, in order to burn amaravati, what do you have to do? Re balishaha, he murkhaha, ayam badavaha shikham pradarshayati parityajata yenam. Oh, no, I think... Amaravatim dagdum adyaiva parityajata. Until that, it should be, after that only there should be a comma. I think the text has a comma at the wrong place. Yeah, it's better to put it like this. Haste kuruta, put him in your hands and then adyaiva, today itself, Amaravatim dagdum, in order to burn Amaravati, yenam parityajata, throw him. So that he can burn the entire city. Re re balishaha, he murkaha. Look at this fellow. Badavaha. Badavagni is, I told you before, that agni which is there in the samudra to keep the samudra in check. I am shikam pradarshayati. He is showing his flames. Iti parihasantaha. See, he is a murkha. He is addressing the devas as murkaha and saying that, look at him. He is showing his flames as if he can do something. Iti parihasantaha, ridiculing him. Parikshipantaha, throwing him here and there. Tarjayantaha, threatening. Tadayantaha, they were hitting him, hitting Agni, and they made him run. Okay? Now, I think we should stop with this. Yeah, because the next one is the friend of Agni is Vayu. The moment Vayu sees the torture that Agni is undergoing or the ridicule that he is facing, Vayu is unable to control Vayu, and he takes on the form that he takes during Pralaya and creates a havoc. Even though he creates a havoc, he will again be reduced to nothing by the asuras. We will see that next week.
Mamdi, I have two questions here.
Yeah.
The Mahanaseshu, what is the Pratipadikam for that?
The Mahanasaha is kitchen.
Mahanasaha. So, yeah. Pulinga Shabdaha?
I don't think there is any Vyutpati there. It is one Shabda, Mahanasaha.
Oh. Mahanasaha. Like Pulinga Shabdaha.
Yes, yes.
Mahanasaha. And that last one. Yeah, that I am Shikham Pradarshayati. That Shikha is here is flame, wow. not the Shikha that Brahmanas wear.
Yes, it is like for Brahmanas it is a Shikha. Here for the Agni, the Shikha is the flame.
Oh, okay.
The Agrabhage yatu vartate tat. So it is the Jwala.
Oh.
Shikha
okay.
is actually that which is there in the Shikhare Sthitam, no?
Oh, okay. Oh, I didn't know that. I mean, Shikha means it comes from Shikare iti aham na
jana. Yeah. Okay. Nice one.